Hello and welcome to a brand new series of, what is this
called? Bromance Plays, or Bromance of the Free Gamers.
Either way, yeah, what is this though? I mean, it's right on the screen.
One Piece, Pirate Warriors 3, Desu? Yo!
We're gonna play...
Yeah, Legend Log. We're gonna play... The Legend?
Fist of the North Star? Not again.
I mean... Yeah, probably not.
Easy. I want to say hard, just because you haven't broken too many level caps.
Yeah, and super hard does...
Finish it up. We're going to do it on hard.
Yeah, because we're not chumps.
Ooh. Check Legend is that.
Yeah, no, I was just looking at it. All right.
Let's do this.
What character do I want to be?
Part 1, Luffy.
So many choices.
I think that's all he gets, part one Luffy.
Change costume.
Alright, to make this fair for you guys,
we're gonna do normal part one Luffy.
Which makes me angry because I just realized that I don't get my favorite move, but it's okay.
What, Gum Gum Red Hawk?
No, Grizzly Magnum.
Hajime-da, look at that mustache. Why do I not have a mustache like that? Because I'm not.
Oh, the Japanese actors are all professionals, but I would love it if just in the middle of it they just snuck a line like that in there.
I left everything I own in one place.
Just so you know, I'm gonna make references. They'll never understand and they'll never know, but I'm just gonna...
We'll get it.
I'm just gonna keep dropping
eventually.
Let's take it with cool!
Yeah!
Let's take it with cool!
And this thing does what the anime didn't do. Start here!
You know, I would like to point out, I think it would have been okay to give him, like, the pig and Benjamin, even if they never were gonna show up on the battlefield.
That would be nice. Because, as supports, at least.
Yeah, because look at this. He's just surrounded by nameless jobbers.
Yeah, even later.
And they're all in enemy outfits.
Exactly.
Even in normal outfits.
I guess it'll make more sense to make red-haired Shanks in red. I wish that the games let you make your own levels and choose which followers you had.
Why is it that he always gets a voice that's not English? You know, Funimation made him Australian. The one we watched that won the One Piece Award.
Yeah, that was in the...
They made him Irish.
It's because he has red hair. It's a kind of easy joke to make about him that he is, you know...
But wait, how's Australian relate to red hair?
I don't know.
That's more of an Irish thing, though.
I don't know. I guess maybe 4Kids
I'm just curious to see what 4Kids do with it. Were they the Australians, or...?
Yeah, they were.
He was Australian.
I feel like 4Kids like was just sitting there. There was
like...
I didn't
even do anything right.
Exactly. That's literally what it sounded like. And Mihawk sounded French, even though
he's
supposed to be Spanish.
Sucked.
Because he's based
like,
off.
Oh, I feel bad for these actors who probably tried hard or were probably found outside of the studio.
No, these were their regulars. These were like their regular cast members, like their full-time voice actors that you always
see.
Well,
thank you. I'm glad you appreciate my job as Sanji.
Oh no, not fuck Sanji. You want to autoplay?
He went to One Piece, and then he found out there was friendship! Everyone was pissed.
You start One Piece, and it's about pirates. Keep track at home, kids. Tell me how long that lasts.
Listen, man, the same could be said about Naruto. We started off as ninjas, then what happened? It became Battle of the Gods.
When we actually watch and read this shit, it is not about pirates. It's about one guy who has anti-authority
problems. Yes, I know.
Problems.
I've been there for you and Josh's rant about how he's not a pirate. He's just an adventurer with anti-government views.
He is!
Well, if you think about it, technically, at least nowadays, I think you're arrested for piracy just for living on a boat and not paying taxes. Which Luffy kind of does.
I don't know. There are IRL pirates that actually do.
IRL?
Yeah.
Real life pirates.
There are some that actually fly Shanks'
flag. Don't you love the fact he's wearing his Enies Lobby outfit all the way in the first act?
Don't you love how Luffy's outfit... Look at Luffy's outfit.
Green shirts are hard to draw.
He didn't have green shirts.
Yeah, a white shirt.
Yeah, it was a white shirt, green pants.
Yeah. Someday.
I remember all his outfits. He's my favorite Straw Hat.
He's everybody's favorite Straw Hat.
No, I think it's either him, Luffy, or Sanji. The Monster Three are almost everyone's favorite, like, Straw Hats.
I bounce back and forth, but I feel like Brook's story might be just slightly sadder than most. Except maybe Robin, because, you know, that got real, real hard.
Yeah!
He's like, we're gonna kill you for learning! Don't kill me for learning! And this is your mom! What? She dies first! Who?
Exactly.
The island's burning. Why?
I love Zoro.
Follow the ice path. Who are you?
How did you burn it down with ice?
You know, they probably should have added his son to this. El Meppo?
They probably should have.
Because they have Vivi and all. They have him and all he does is show up in like a still shot.
He shows up in a still shot. He shows
Vivi
up
only shows up in a still shot. She has no in-character model.
Yeah, but sure again, the only fighting the she really did in the show was Nameless Jobbers. And the only named characters she ever took down in the show were Mr. Seven and Miss Father's Day.
But
and they were just the noobs guarding the gun.
But
PlayStation thinks I can't record this.
But let's think. what is it?
I've got to get him to
join
my crew.
They don't even put Shirahoshi in the game as like a still, or even her father. The whole reason they were there on, you know. You don't get that until like.
You gotta fight a bunch of bullshit.
No, you gotta beat. You gotta, I think, complete the log.
I already completed the log.
No, I mean, I think the treasury. We gotta do something, I forget.
But at least we have all the moves.
Yep. Come on, go no storm! Which was never used that way.
No, but Koei had to be creative, because.
Yes, they did.
It was either be creative or ask Oda for details.
You don't do that. No, Mike, you know what we're gonna do? We're gonna start this now.
Yeah?
Berserk Guy is a boss! Oda is a chump! We're doing it, Mike. We're bringing.
We're gonna bring that conversation we had, which was probably the most fucked up conversation we had about two artists.
And we're gonna bring it up again in Berserk, because then we're gonna really talk about how awesome Berserk Guy is. Well, have we started off, Mike? We made Ichiro Oda like this parent.
Well, we were talking, I think, about how. What was it? We were saying about how we're sick and tired of some of the people going on, like, break. Like,
yeah.
The Hunter Cross Hunter guy, he goes on break a lot.
Berserk guy
does. And we're talking about how he likes to just, you know, watch his dating sims and things like that. But, like, at least not like Oda, who works all the fucking time.
Still doesn't get anything done.
Yep.
Puts it out almost weekly. But then we were talking about how he goes home when he's trying to talk to his wife about
he's a fucking failure.
His wife hates him and thinks he's a failure.
His kids don't like him. And he's just so depressed because he's like, oh, I've been doing this for so long. And then he tries to figure out how to make One Piece better. And we tell him he goes to Berserk Guy and he's like, use rape. If he gets raped. What? It's a shonen. It's like,
I'm sorry. Nami gets raped. That's bad.
No, that's not, I didn't come to you for rape. It's like, well, why did you come to me then? You're right. What was I thinking?
I wanted advice on working harder.
I have failed.
The guy just slowly turns his computer chair around from his dating sim, pants undone, just like, what did you want?
No. Yeah, we turned Berserk Guy into a boss. He's just like, yeah, you know, I used to be like you. I used to put out manga chapters every week. And then I realized I'm fucking awesome. Berserk rocks! No said!
Berserk rocks so hard, they will wait 15 years for a new chapter.
Exactly!
And they'll read it again when I start.
And then we just turn to Oda even more. He's like, I can't do that. He's like, yeah, we know. Because you suck. We literally turned Oda into this horrible excuse of a human being.
About how actually it's the reverse. If you write a bunch of comedies and they're all happy and things like that, you're actually either depressed or fucking violent and sociopathic.
Whereas if you write the most violent
and evil shit, you're actually a good person.
Exactly, so Berserk Guy is literally just he's just a bamf, he doesn't care what you think, but he's also a nice person. He's like, you know, I know I write about it, but I don't believe in rape. It's bad. But I just do it because, you know, medieval ages, right? That's That was the everyday occurrences. You walk out your barn trying to do your daily life.
That's just
and
how I
get raped.
That's how
what?
I play D&D, you know.
Just running around teabagging ectoplasm.
You don't get the right to comment on my awesome teabagging skills.
Not until I watch you fall in the ocean again.
Stomp!
You remember that time in, whatchamacallit, when Luffy went third gear? I remember. Patrick Farms remembers. God damn it, child!
You suck. Oda! Oda! Don't take advice from Berserk Guy, but take advice from Berserk Guy. But don't take the wrong advice, take the right advice.
Take the advice that counts.
Take the advice about getting good at drawing.
I don't know, the One Piece art style is very nice, it's just...
You know what, Bob? I need to find you a picture of Guts drawn in his most recent adaptation. You compare the detail in Guts to One Piece, and you're like, Jesus, man, this guy is an art.
Yeah, that's one of the things that I was talking to my friend at work about. He was saying that... I was talking about One Piece, and he's like, yeah, I can't really get into One Piece. He's like, because I hate the art style, and I was like... You know,
does he mean the anime or does he mean the manga?
No, just in general. He hates how Oda draws.
That's fair. You don't have to.
Like he doesn't like this kind of look. Like, I mean, it looks kind of nice in 3D sometimes, but
I don't know. I like his draw. Some of his characters I like when they're drawn. Like he's. I'm not saying that's
when he goes out of his way to draw them nice. They're really nice, but
yeah.
When he doesn't, you can see.
When he's just kind of passing through this island.
That being said, though, Berserk Guy puts a lot of detail into his characters, even some side jobbers. But Guts, oh my god, if you look at Guts in the most recent ones he does, like the 2000s and onward, he got a lot better, man.
Berserk
Guy, literally, he's a manga artist, but he's also an artist. Like, he's honed that craft. Like, you see that, and you understand why, yeah, it's okay. Yeah, we're cool, you know. It's cool that you want to take this time off because
you're actually drawing something and you're not, you know, just throwing it up. Like, even Naruto at some point.
I love the fact we keep calling him Berserk Guy, but we don't call him by his real name because we don't know what his real name is.
Because we just don't remember their name.
I don't remember his name. If it's not Oda...
And the only reason you remember Oda is because you liked that game so much.
What? Oh, yeah.
Ichiro Oda? It's because it's an easy name to remember.
Yeah. The only reason we call him Oda is just because that's his last name.
Yeah.
Oh no, I was just making a joke about the Nobu Naga.
And the fact that I do like One Piece a lot.
Treasure event!
Out of all the big ones, One Piece is my favorite. Bob can attest to that. I have almost all the English volumes that have come out so far.
Until he stopped caring.
It's not that I don't stop caring, it's that I don't have time to read.
And they're kind of expensive.
They are.
And they're kind of samey.
Not as expensive, though, as a Berserk chapter. A Berserk manga, that's like $14+ sometimes, because that's treated as a freaking comic book by Dark Horse.
Yeah.
The Thoroughbred of Sin?
No, that's Rape Horse. get your horses right, buddy.
Horse. I love how she has the thing wrapped around her arm.
Yeah, I know, before they ever get to that point.
Mostly because she's not in the right outfit at all.
No, yeah, they did not draw the first outfit.
She didn't draw... She's never in that outfit. She's never in that outfit. They always give Robin her Enies Lobby outfit.
I think you can unlock the cowgirl outfit later.
I don't think so.
I don't know if there was a
No, you can. You're right, you can. Yeah. But that's the only time she gets to wear her...
original outfit.
Yep. Gotta get to that Zoro.
I do.
I don't know. I just hope this year... Well, he is doing season 2 of Berserk, but there's no way he can do a 12-part anime with what they're saying the next season is.
Oh, did he get the second guy? Yeah.
Nice. The second season?
Yeah, what's this?
Millennium, the thing I told you, I just
finished Millennium Falcon,
which is his longest chapter with 100, and his longest arc. It has 130 chapters, and it started in 1997, and it ended in 2010.
Go further. There you go.
So he did it for more than 10 years. It took him to finish.
And you go the long way. Look at this map we built.
It took him 10 long years, I think, to finish one arc.
I mean, that's not that bad.
Not that bad.
And, I mean, 10 years.
For an arc.
For an arc. And I assume it's, I mean...
Welcome to Dressrosa.
How?
No, Dressrosa.
Oh, no, I know.
Oda wishes he could probably get away with that.
Oh, he could never get away. Because he's got shonen, so he can never get away with that.
No, he can't.
It was just like, no. Nobody cares about Bleach. Nobody cares about Naruto's son. Nobody cares about Naruto anymore.
Yeah, people care about Naruto.
People care about Naruto.
I wish Crunchyroll would let me watch it, but that's for premium only.
That's why everybody wants to read Boltero, because they're just like, oh my god, Naruto might be dead. What happened?
That was the only hook, but after that, you tell me it's pretty much just me watching...
It's just the fucking
movie. I don't care.
They didn't add that. Like, that's the problem. Like, if they added more to the movie, I could live with the where they are in the arc. It's just like, whatchamacallit? Fucking Akira Toriyama, oh man, I'm gonna go make the manga, it'll be once a month. The show is so much further ahead than he is.
Yeah, isn't it like two arcs ahead of him?
Yeah. Like, I think they...
Because he just finally got into the Zemetsu arc, I think?
Yeah, I think they just got into the Future Trunks arc again.
Oh, what?
Somebody's dead.
What the? Everyone's dead. I'm the man who's gonna be the Pirate King.
They really do draw a good line between, here's regular people with regular old guns, and Luffy can beat them because he's stretchy. Then he gets to the grand line. Yeah, no, everyone can kill you now.
No.
Then he gets to the new world.
Nah, to be fair, it's... Enies Lobby is where it really became everyone can kick your ass.
Everyone you're gonna go against can kill you now.
That's not true. You're gonna take on the whole world government at once. Don't.
And let's be honest, most of the people he fought beforehand could have killed him. They were just either dicking around or Luffy got lucky.
Buggy.
Luffy got lucky with Crocodile because Robin saved him the one time.
And he was just stupid persistent.
Yep.
The only reason he won was because his blood had water in it, which let him hurt Crocodile.
The only reason he won against Enaru is because he's the natural deterrent to Enaru. He's rubber, and Enaru was lightning.
The only reason why he wins against Rob Lucci is because...
He cheated.
Perseverance, and...
Well, that's...
Well, because he found a super technique that would make him stronger while shortening his life. Welcome to Shonen.
No, that's been... I guarantee you that's been subjugated.
No, they said...
Oh, no, that's what I'm saying. That's what it was. He doesn't do that anymore.
He's also... They said he figured that out way beforehand.
Yeah, so I guarantee you when he was... Yeah, because he wanted to make it like, this is high stakes. It's like, no, because what you're going to do is you're going to... Yeah, and what did he do? He popped it now. Even in Thriller Bark, he would pop second gear, even if it was this dangerous thing.
Yep.
And then what happened? Time skip? Yeah, he can just pop whenever he wants. It's almost like, why... Why would you even stay regular Luffy when apparently second gear, you can just pop into it at any second?
Apparently he can just hold it for longer now because he can't hold it indefinitely.
Second?
Second, yeah.
I thought you can hold second indefinitely and third indefinitely because they don't.
He found a way past them. He found a way to make it so that their effects don't affect him as much, as long as he's not doing it for long periods of time.
Well, then you know,
It's why he can go into third gear and not turn into a child anymore, because he figured out a way to make it so that he optimizes it. You notice how, like, when he goes in the third gear in here, he goes in the third gear, like, he blows the entire arm up?
Yep.
But when you see later on, he's only going to blow up a small portion.
Or he can also just crack his wrist. No, actually, cracking the wrist sets in second gear.
Yeah.
Which I do find, which I'm kind of, I don't know, it's cool, but still, that was kind of cool when he put his, when he did the whole, like...
Yeah. When he had to activate it.
But now he can just flick his wrist and he can just activate.
And now he's got to do... He does fourth gear pretty much the same
way he did third. Which was cool, it was just... It gave a measurement of power. We had an idea that this thing he was doing was hard to do.
Yeah, but he...
And then the very first thing he does is like... Yeah, no, forget what you heard. It's what you're hearing.
What? It's what you're hearing. What?
What you're hearing. Listen!
What? Listen! Loof gonna give it to you. Fuck waiting for your own...
This gear thing... is mine!
My mother, Humpers?
Humpers, we still on four kids?
Hell no, yeah.
Never again.
This gear shit is mine! Motherfuckers, it's not a fucking dream!
I was gonna have that's when Zoro pops in.
It's not a fucking game! Fuck what you heard! We're fighting real people now!
Oh yeah, that quest to be the best. How's that fighting Mihawk thing going? I begged him to give me lessons, and he did.
Only so he could fight me later.
Just so I can get to the second area of my training.
You know what it is? Mihawk's that trainer. He's that master that will train the people who will defeat him because he wants to be challenged. He's like, I see you got potential. I'll train you so you can beat me one day.
Let's be honest, what I see happening in the finale, I see Zoro fighting Mihawk, and that's not going to be the big fight. Zoro versus Fujitora is probably going to be the big fight.
I don't know. Fujitora doesn't look like he wouldn't.
Fujitora is a blind swordsman. He's that stereotypical.
Yeah, but he's also
proven... He might, but we've built up Mihawk a lot, though we've hinted a lot at...
Yeah, but we've also proven that he's not... Well, he's pretty fine with Luffy and his crew.
Yeah, but he still is gonna... He's probably gonna end up fighting them. I kind of see that happening.
Yeah, he'll probably end up fighting each of them. I couldn't promise you which one's gonna be first, which one's gonna be last, but he's probably gonna end up fighting each of them.
Well, Luffy has to fight Ikino again.
Luffy is probably gonna go through a boss rush.
Yeah.
That's how I see it.
And the last two are probably gonna be Akinu and Blackbeard.
I was gonna say it's probably gonna be if he's fighting just the World Cup, it's probably gonna be he's gonna fight Akinu and then somebody in the Garrosi, because it's probably gonna turn out like the Garrosi.
No, the way I see it as if he's gonna do the.
I did hear a theory that the Garrosi might be immortal.
All I know is if he's gonna do what he says and end this in 300 chapters, he's just gonna make the world. He's gonna make the war everything, pirates, world government, and Luffy's just gonna be on a three sided.
Professor and Marianne.
Pretty much.
I'm just waiting for the chapter where it's like, Straw Hat, I am Akainu, I know who you are, I am Akainu, and I have captured everyone you liked from East Blue. Come at me.
Except for your grandfather, he came willingly.
Except for your grandfather, he still kind of wants my head. Don't know why though. I'll kill you because of what you did to Ace! He keeps saying that.
You were gonna do it first. I was gonna do it gently.
He turns and he looks at me, he's like, it looks like I've got an ace up my sleeve. You know what's even worse about that?
That would be great.
He punched him through the chest.
Some people have an ace up his sleeve. I was just gonna say, some people have an ace up their sleeve. I have ace on my sleeve, and it won't come off.
There you go.
Lucky I went red.
Can you call me a crewmate? You know what sucked is that they gave that to Law during when it was Dressrosa and everyone thought Law was gonna join. Eh.
Called it! Hints! Well, Illuminati!
He's not gonna join.
No, but I can see him being a helper for a while.
Yeah, he's gonna be like Vivi. Vivi, but he's gonna be a more helpful Vivi.
Luminosuke's almost a more helpful Vivi because he can turn into a dragon and hear the elephant.
Oh, kick to the face, chump.
That's Monosuke.
Princess Mononoke? I love that movie.
Yeah. What was I saying?
I don't know, but look at these drivers.
I also see Sanji probably having to fight Barcelona.
Borsalino?
Yeah. Because if you look at the way Barcelona uses a lot of his moves, there's a lot of kicks.
No, yeah, I saw it in the opening theme. You gotta check out the anime now, just because of how much filler they put in the beginning. Just like, they go through the theme song.
Oh, I know.
Then when you come back from commercial, you go to a description of what the adventure is, and then a description of who all the Straw Hats are, and then a description of the last few episodes, which were mostly this series.
I told you about that when I was watching Dressrosa. I told you
both about that too when I watched it. I was like, what the fuck, it's like a 5-minute episode because it's 25 minutes of just recap and then hinting at what's going to happen next time.
Oh no, like, now that we're on Zo, it's not recap. It's a third of it's recap. A third of it is just different shots of people reacting to things. Like when all the minks were running into town to look at the samurai, we got 7 different shots of each group running. It's like, here's them running head on. Here's them running from behind. Here's them from the northwest. From the northeast. From the pure west.
One of my other friends at work, I kept telling him about what was going on in the thing. He's like, oh my god, that's so much more interesting. And I was like, and you're probably still in filler too. And he's like, yeah, we're still in filler. And then he would try to tell me about it, and he's like, literally, it's in a 5-minute episode. And I was like, you know, the comments are free.
You finally did it, you brat.
You brought worst.
Stop it! It's clear you aren't crewmates. Thank you.
Why didn't they put that guy in there?
No, no.
And that one almost works as a jobber because he was kind of a jobber.
Yeah, but he's like one of the few black characters in the show. I don't need this guy.
If we don't count Dawes Bones, and I think it was just that one guy from Buggy's crew who never showed up again.
You mean the super racist one? He was black. He was pretty much, you know, blackface.
He pretty much was Popo.
Yep.
Popo 2.0.
Oh, isn't that cute?
I think they even turned him blue.
No, they turned him white.
Oh, yeah.
Japan's history of whitewashing needs to go down. I am so tired. No, I'm not.
I will become a marine officer!
Okay.
You will. You want to aim a little higher there, sport?
Oh, snap. They changed the cover for One Piece suit.
Hey, is that Sabo?
Oh, that's Bleach!
It's
Sanji?
Sanji, yeah.
Oh, this week's chapter, right?
Yeah.
Screw Bartholomew. I don't like him. I never liked him.
Bartolomeo?
Yeah,
I think he's hilarious.
I never liked him.
I wanted to like him, but at the same time, I had that little thought in my head. Just like, is Oda actually mad at his fans?
Yes. We'll meet again, Kobe!
Front piece request. Sea turtles bawling their eyes out as they listen to Bartholomew and Gambia recount tears in their eyes, anecdotes of the Straw Hats.
And that's going to be it, guys. What an episode. 27 minutes, damn.